Then we have the first thing on our agenda, it's a presentation from the union. And welcome City Hall, glad to have you here. Glad to have you sing.
Thank you, it's my pleasure to be here. My name is Gregory Lewis, I'm Vice President for Financial Affairs. And with me is David Gordon, our Director of Facilities. Let me first say that it is certainly a pleasure to be here. And also, it is not only a pleasure, but it is a very exciting time at Virginia Union University. We are in the process, and in a minute here I'll point it out to you, but we are in the process of building a new living and learning center. And it will be the first building, first new building we've built on campus for some 15 years and over 40 years for a residence hall. So we are certainly pleased to be here today to present this plan to you. And not only is it just a plan, but it certainly is the essence, it embodies our long-term strategic plan. We passed out a handout today that identifies the additions that we are making to the master plan. In 2002, we presented the master plan in October to the Planning Council, and then in November of 2012, in December 2002, that original master plan was approved. And in November of 2012, there were some additions made to that. And the first addition, as I mentioned earlier, we will be building, in fact, December 4th, will be the groundbreaking for the new construction of the Living and Learning Center, 78,000 square feet, 240 beds, 120 men, 120 women, and in the center will be a conference center with a main banquet hall that will accommodate up to 450 people. We certainly believe that not only will it be a showcase for the university, but also for Richmond. The second addition is the Health and Life Science Building, which we just north of Graham. And the third, we will have to relocate our current tennis courts, basketball courts, and therefore we intend to create more of a sports complex. And those items are listed as number three, consisting of the basketball courts, doing some minor renovation to the entrance of a football stadium, and adding a softball field. And then, because of losing parking space, we also have developed a plan to do a new parking garage, which should accommodate somewhere between 300 to 400 cars. And the fifth addition will be a major renovation to the old maintenance building, which would be mainly used to for the business development center. And then the sixth and final item, part of our plan, is a campus parking and pedestrian traffic modification, which should increase perimeter parking, campus quad, and ample theater. Questions?
Any questions?
Yes. I'm an old union alumnus. I'm excited about what I'm seeing here. This is
Thank you.